So we are here at the Anthropology Research Facility at the University of Tennessee, and this is the first human decomposition facility in the world. And this was established in 1981. We're actually celebrating our 35th anniversary of our body donation program.
For the body farm to open this up to us, to NCIS, is huge. This is, I think, one of the first NCIS-only classes to have 18 of us here at one time. Really gives us the ability to take this back to our field offices, because we're from all over the place. And when we have a major scene, we've got individuals scattered all over the country that can apply this knowledge and be on scene immediately, rather than waiting for someone who has been had the training to get there, you know, hours or maybe even a day later. I've been absolutely amazed at the amount of respect that's shown to the human donors by not only the faculty but the students, and the entire process is very respectful. Everyone's very grateful to be able to use these human donors to study human decomposition and the recovery of human remains. So it's very impressive to work with the folks here.
So the training that we offer for law enforcement is very unique. They have the experience of working with experts. We do this every day, and we're also teachers, so we're fairly good at relaying the knowledge that we have in a way that law enforcement can appreciate, because we also work with law enforcement every day on cases. So unlike donating to medical schools, where the bodies are really only used for about 6 months or maybe a year, then they're cremated and returned to the families, there's really no end to the gift of body donation program here, because the research on the skeletons could go on forever.
So we were able to bring our 3D technology out here to the body farm and kind of test it out in a training scenario before we deploy it to the field. We've got our 3D scanner set up on tripods. We were able to actually do a 3D scan of the burial site itself. So while that scanner is scanning, it's collecting millions and millions of points, both laser distance data as well as color data, and we're able to combine that into a 3D point cloud. So we're able to reproduce that at a later time. It's great for a courtroom presence, kind of countering that CSI effect in the courtroom, and allows you to go back months, years, decades later, say in a cold case scenario, and actually examine the scene as it was to a very high degree of accuracy.